Here's something Joe Biden had to say recently, by the way. This is who Joe Biden is. It's a powerful video, by the way. It's a very powerful video. Here, hold up.
I'm an Air Force veteran. I'm here with Army veterans. Just wondering why we should vote for a war in the thousands of our brothers and sisters.
So Joe Biden is being confronted by two Iraq war veterans. And the gentleman said to him, you know, why should we vote for someone who enabled this war that killed so many of our brothers and sisters? And let's watch all this unfold.
You also gave a medal to the man who was able to work on something. Your blood is on your hands.
If I truly believed that the people in that room, with exception, of course, of those two veterans, but everybody else in that room, was representative of how this country really felt and was representative of what this country is, we deserve Trump. We deserve it. I don't believe that. I don't believe that that room was representative of what this country really is and the people who live here. Those were two veterans who confronted Joe Biden about his support for the Iraq War, a very fair confrontation. And Joe Biden just moved the goalpost and dismissed them. And while they're pleading that their friends are dead, that their brothers and sisters are dead, that they sent them over there to kill civilians in this disastrous war that should have never happened, people are trying to drown them out by chanting for the man who helped enable that war. Joe Biden's been getting it wrong for 30 plus years. And by the way, whenever he's gotten it right, it was on accident, by the way. Like these people were like, oh, well, gay marriage, Joe Biden came around first. No, he didn't. Public opinion demanded it. The movement was too strong. So Obama was like, yeah, we got to come around on this. We got to do gay marriage. And then Joe Biden just said it on air first. That's all that happened. Joe Biden didn't push Obama anywhere. A movement pushed Obama. You can find footage of all of them, Obama, Joe Biden, Hillary Clinton, being against gay marriage. Until they couldn't be anymore. So when people give Joe Biden for that's such a misguided assessment of what actually happened. That's why Joe Biden has never gotten close in any of his runs for president. The only memorable thing from any one of his former campaigns was that he plagiarized speeches from other politicians. That's the only thing people remember. Because he stands for absolutely nothing. And he never has. And you can find footage of him saying, hey man, I was just ready to prostitute myself. To him, that's what a politician is. That's what a politician does. You just take big checks and do the bidding of the people who gave you the big check. That's why, again, I think Pete Buttigieg was more dangerous than Joe Biden, because Pete Buttigieg actually knows better. He actually knows what a politician should do. He chooses not to, because that ain't easy street. Joe Biden, honestly, doesn't know. So people were like, well, at least he's smarter than Trump. Is he? Are you sure? You're comparing vomit to vomit. That's what you're doing. It's like you're assessing a pile of puke. And you're like, well, this one has a full noodle in it. The other one is just completely decomposed. And I think just mostly liquor. How about we don't pick a pile of vomit? How about we don't do that? I mean, that's unbelievable. That's unbelievable. Oh, and by the way, that's how war veterans are treated in a public space. You know, it's so amazing. You go to a sporting event and they get everyone to stand up and clap for a war veteran. Yet when war veterans have something to say, you chant over them. Or when war veterans run for president, you do everything you can to keep them off a debate stage they should be on, like Tulsi Gabbard. They're already trying to change the rules to make sure she can't be on that debate. And could you imagine a debate? Could you imagine? I mean, just for a pleasant image in your head for a second, imagine a debate where it was Joe Biden, Bernie Sanders, and Tulsi Gabbard. Those three in a debate. That could single-handedly end Joe Biden's campaign. I mean, honestly, a debate like that could single-handedly end Joe Biden's campaign. And then, hey, in a perfect world, at least the way I see it, that would end Joe Biden's campaign. Bernie would announce Tulsi as his running mate. We'd get a Bernie-Tulsi ticket. That'd be pretty cool. But, man. Who's inspired by that? Joe Biden, instead of saying, you know what, I made a mistake on Iraq, and I promise you I'm never going to make that mistake again, and I salute you for your service. And my son was over there too, so I know the pain, I know the loss, and I salute you for your service. He didn't do that. He just moved the goalposts and then threatened the guy. He threatened, oh, you better not. You better not be. Did you hear that part? Where he said, oh, you better not be. You think you could beat that guy in push-ups, Joe? I don't think you could, pal. Would you threaten that guy if it was just you and him alone in a room, Joe? You're a tough guy, Joe. You're a tough guy. You're real tough. This guy, they want that guy to run against Trump. The guy who can't hold his composure in the slightest. When a Latino activist confronts him on immigration because he's scared for the people in his community, he tells that guy to just go vote for Trump. When someone asks him, hey, what are you going to do about climate change? He says, go vote for someone else. Go vote for Sanders. When a veteran confronts him about Iraq, he moves the goalpost to make it about his son. That guy was not criticizing his son or saying anything bad about his son. He moves the goalpost. And then when the guy says, hey, I'm not saying anything about your son, man. That's not what this is about. He goes, oh, you better not. Real tough, Joe, when you got a room full of people chanting against two war veterans who had to go fight in your bullshit war. This guy who melts under the smallest of scrutinies, who can't handle a debate question, who every debate has had protesters interrupt his closing statement. They're going to throw that guy against Donald Trump. Donald Trump will crush him. And the Democrats know that. You don't think the Democrats know he can't win? They do. They don't care because they'd rather lose to Trump again than actually have something that upsets the status quo because they love the status quo. And you know who else loves the status quo? Karl Rove. And at the end of the day, we got one party. It's the money party. And the money goes to war. So there you go. There you go. Karl Rove. Loving Joe Biden. Joe Biden might save the Democratic Party. That's what he means, by the way, with Democratic Party. He means that. What you just saw from Joe Biden. Look at that clip. Is that worth saving? You want to see that saved? All right. So, there you go. That video has over 1 million views. Please share it and retweet it, and let's get it 1 million more. Because I don't see how anyone could see that and think, yeah, that's a leader. How anyone could see somebody treat veterans that way and say, yeah, that's a leader. And I'm going to retweet it right now.
Get your news on with Ron. Don't you want to know what's going on? We're getting our news on today. Get your news on with Ron. Don't you want to know what's going on? We're getting our news on today. Yeah, yeah, yeah. You can tweet me an article at Ron Placone. We'll go through it together and